Can I ask gateway sale? Gateway sale. Thank you. I'm ready to receive. Thank you.
A string of victories around the city, and very quickly the siege is lifted. Just again within a week of the arrival of Joan of Arc, and Joan of Arc again is wounded carrying her back. banner, her white famous white banner.
Doesn't she get shot in the neck?
Yes, and later at Paris, she's also shot in the knee at the same time, so she does suffer, even though it's debated as to whether she actually physically fought, whether she was just hurling a banner around and acting as, you know, this source of spiritual strength of the French armies is contested as to whether she actually killed anyone.
It's worth mentioning, just on the subject of miracles, too, and I can't remember if it was the commander or the deputy commander at Orléans, is actually struck randomly by a French cannonball, is incapacitated and dies within a week, and that really affects the English prospects at Orléans, and then from that point on, they sort of prevail.
Well, again, you can almost say the even more incredible side of this is the fact that after this, I mean, this is taken as a sign by many that Joan of Arc and her association with St. Michael is genuine, and that she is some sort of divine apparition, some divine representative to the people there. And from that point of view, it's remarkable that she actually makes the military decision. She makes the decision to go after Reims, not to go after Paris, so that the campaign can be sanctified by the coronation of Charles VII. In particular, why this is significant is because Henry had been, he was still a child, he was going to be crowned much later. There was no need to crown him in Reims at such a young age, unless it was a sign of desperation, essentially. So the incredible thing about this is not only that she's able to convince, in particular, the lead French commander, the Duke of Alençon, to attack Reims, not only is it successful, but the first military engagement across the River Loire at the Battle of Pendai is a decisive French victory in which the English are basically annihilated, leaving the road to Reims, you know, completely open, essentially. Towns such as, with the exception of Loire, which would be the centre of the treaty, you know, establishing English rule over France, cities after city, town after town, surrendered to the Dauphin without a fight, essentially, and he was crowned in Reims before, again, Henry VI was crowned, and when Henry VI was ultimately crowned, he was crowned in the Northern Abbey, which again doesn't have any of that symbolic significance which the coronation of Reims has. So right from the beginning, right from here, due to Joan of Arc's intervention, you can always say directly, Charles VII has massively, within a year, saved the prospects of the developmental dynasty. However, in terms of her own military invincibility, is then followed up by two disasters. The French prematurely decide to attack Paris, and the English are able to resist and hold on to the encampment for several more years. Then there is subsequently a truce, and when the truce is broken, she is under siege of Compiègne, now this time against the Burgundians. At the siege of Compiègne, she is captured, and the English pay the Burgundians to deliver her to Rouen, which, as we mentioned, the walls setting up Normandy as the central base of operation. Rouen is where they tried to demystify her and remove this air of sanctity to her by declaring her to be, you know, either heretic, witch, whatever, something that would remove all the spiritual validity which had been conferred by her onto the course of Charles VII.
Thank you guys very much for joining me here at Salvation Army. Make sure you donate all your wanted, unwanted goods to your local thrift store. Thank you.